Very good morning to all. My name is Vikram Neergatti. Welcome to the webinar on Internet of Things, Applications and its Research Issues, organized by KPRIET, KPR Institute of Engineering and Technology, Coimbatore. The content which that I would like to plan to deliver in this session is Introduction to IoT, What, Why and How, Applications, and finally about the research issues. So in introduction to IoT, we'll see what is an IoT, why we need to go for IoT, and how we need to implement an IoT. So what? If you see in this slide, one patient is lying on the bed and the two nurses are assisting them, and on top of them we have some sensors. You can see some gadgets is here. So here what we're trying to do is we connecting these two people and some other things to the internet and storing the data to the cloud. And if you see in this image, we have a something like smart factory, smart city, smart hospital, smart highway, etc., etc. In each and every place, what we're trying to do is we connecting the things to the internet. So here we have one definition, like Internet of Things is the internet working of physical devices, vehicles, building and other items embedded with electronics, software, sensors, actuators and network connectivity that enable these objects to collect and exchange the data. So with these slides, we can conclude that Internet of Things means we are connecting the things around us to the internet. In simple, things around us connecting to the internet is called a Internet of Things. So why we need to connect these kind of things to the internet? So for the automation purpose, without human intervention, the things should be done automatically. For example, the water in front of our house in a garden should be automatically watering every day in the morning and in the evening. Automatically the lights and fans should get on whenever we enter into the home. Like that, some automation stuff can be done, and generally users develop the application for to live comfort. And this is very, very important one. We taking the data to the cloud, and inside the cloud we analyzing the data, that which leads to many applications. For example, in the smart home applications or etc., we can able to save the energy based upon this automation. And while getting this data to the cloud, we can able to analyze the data and we can take the better decisions. And as I said before, with IoT, human intervention will be very less. So how really we can able to implement this IoT? Like humans, the way humans works, similarly we making the machines to work like that. What is the way of working of the human? Humans has some sense organs, brain and the speak. Sense organs will act as an input, the brain will act as a process, and the speaking will act as an output. So with the help of sense organs, ears, nose, skin, we have different sense organs. We will sense the environment and our brain will process. Based upon that, we can able to speak or we can able to nod our head or shaking, etc., etc. So this is the process we are doing for the humans. The same process we are doing for the machines as well. That is called the Internet of Things. You can see here. We have some sensors. We will embed the sensors inside the things. And the sensors will collect the data from the environment and take to the microcontroller. The microcontroller process the information and that will send to the actuators. That's how the Internet of Things will play a role. So clearly we need to know that we need sensors is there, like a master level sensor, light intensity sensor, PIR, passive infrared sensor, infrared sensor. Like that, we have many sensors is there, temperature sensor. So with the help of the temperature, with the help of the sensors, we can able to sense the values around the environment, and that we will take to the microcontroller. This microcontroller, or you can use the microprocessor as well. So what is a microcontroller? It's a specific purpose. Microprocessor means general purpose. So you can use depending upon your requirement. That will process the information and sends the actuators output. Like maybe light is getting on or off, fan is getting on or off, reducing the speed or increase. This is the output devices based upon the temperature. If temperature is very more, means the AC levels will get less automatically. That is the actuator. So this all things, with the help of the sensors, microcontroller, actuators, we will connect these things to the internet. And from the internet, we have a cloud where we can able to do analyze and things. This is how we will implement the internet of things. So this we need to get a knowledge in the sensors, microcontrollers, actuators, and we require a knowledge in the programming like C and the Python. And we will connect this all things with the help of a Wi-Fi internet connectivity, and thus data will be stored in the cloud. In the cloud, we will use the machine learning or deep learning algorithms, and we will analyze the data. Based upon that, we can take the appropriate decisions. This is how the internet of things will works. Next part, we will see the applications which we all are patented. First is a multi-purpose cart, multi-purpose chair, cyber stalking, status of alcoholic person, smart home, academic mini laboratory, automatic attendance monitoring system, IoT enabled COVID-19 mask, kitchen dishwasher, electric network recommendation systems, automatic railway gate system, detection of overload of the vehicles, dustbin management system. These all are the applications which we are patented in the name of the smart nuts and bolts, and few of these products already in the market, and customers are very much satisfied with these applications. And now let us discuss these applications one by one. These all applications you can check in the Indian patent website, in the patent search, and you can able to get the full draft as well. You can download and you can able to do it out. And if you really require that kind of products, we can supply to you. First is a multi-purpose cart. Nowadays we have a many cards like PAN card, a driving license, Aadhaar card, and if you have two or three banks, means two or three ATMs, credit cards, like that. From birth to death, we have many cards. We need to carry many cards in our pocket or in our wallet or etc. etc. So the idea behind here is all the cards are integrated in the cloud. To that cloud, we will provide the access with only one card. That is the multi-purpose card. So with the help of a OTP mechanism or any other authentication mechanisms, biometric or fingerprint, facial recognition, etc., we will provide the access to this cloud, so that with the help of one card, we can able to access any cards from birth to death. This is the idea of the multi-purpose card. Next, multi-purpose chair. So with this chair, we can put implant the sensors here. For example, in the healthcare, we will put a sensors to check the BP level, sugar level, ECG, and etc. In office chair or in a school chair, we can able to put sensors where you can able to switch on the light, switch on the fan, etc. And some weight sensor on bottom of the chair. Whenever the person sitting on the chair, automatically the fan or AC on top of us may get on or off. This is how the automation will be done in this multi-purpose chair. And next, going for the cyber stalking. In this application, a girl may talk in the phone, some Y person will call to the girl X from SIM 1 or from SIM 2 or from SIM 3 or from SIM 4. So same person is calling from different SIMs here, different mobile numbers. The girl, he is teasing him. The girl is getting headache or etc. etc. Lot of trouble with this guy. At that time, what we can do means we can able to track this person, that he may call from different numbers, but with the help of the voice recognition, we can able to track him, and we can decide he is the person calling from different mobile numbers to the same girl this time, and etc. etc. How we can do this means with the help of AI and machine learning algorithms. So speech recognition methods. This is how we can able to save the persons or the victims who are facing the problem with the help of the mobile calls. Next, the status of alcohol person. As per the survey, 90 to 95% of human beings in the world are consuming the alcohol. So some person, the person who may consume the alcohol or may feel very bad and he can't able to stop consuming the alcohol, but he want to take some preventive measures that whenever he consume the required sufficient amount of alcohol, he need to stop it out. And the family persons are suffering a lot with this guy. So this application, what it will do means, it will know the status of the person. Status of the person in the sense, how much percentage of alcohol consumed by him, based upon the alcoholic sensor or based upon the way he talk, the automatic it will recognize and it will say the percentage of the alcohol consumed by him, and it will suggest the three suggestions. First one is, he is all right, this much of percent consumed. He is consumed more, so he required some support to take him to the home. Third one, he consumed very much alcohol, so better need to go to the hospital. Like this, automatically this device will give the suggestions to the individual or to the family members. The message will go to the family members or doctors or etc. etc. This is about this. Next, smart home application. This is a home. If you see, in home we have many lights or fans or sofa, AC, many things is there. Each and everything can be operated with the help of your mobile phone. You can able to switch on the curtain, switch off the curtain. You can able to switch on the light or fan or AC, and you can able to increase the intensity of light or decrease the intensity of light. And you can able to increase the speed of the fan or decrease the speed of the fan with the help of a mobile phone. And in this, we are doing three things. Three in the sense, with the help of a normal switch. Generally, now we are operating the light or the fan with the help of a switch, right? We can able to do with the help of a switch, or we can able to do the switch in the phone, or you can able to do with the help of a voice as well. These three things are doing in the smart home automation. Many of customers are already using this product and they're feeling very comfort with this kind of smart home automation devices. So what is the use of these devices means, we can able to comfortably, we can able to switch on and switch off, and we can save the energy as well. Next is academic mini laboratory. Very important for the academic purpose. This is a laboratory where it is embedded with lot of sensors and lot of actuators and with some microcontrollers. What the students need to do is, just they need to dump the code and see the results. This is how the kit will work. So we have the many sensors like infrared sensor, a moisture level sensor, LDR sensor, buzzer, actuators, light, fan, etc. etc. with two microcontrollers. So with this kit, automatically the students can do the many applications, hundreds of applications. So this kit is directly supplied to the academic purpose, where nowadays they started the Internet of Things branch, and they have a separate course on the Internet of Things. So all the Internet of Things course experimental can be done with the help of this academic mini laboratory kit. Even they can able to operate with the help of a mobile phone as well. We have Wi-Fi embedded here, Bluetooth embedded here. You can able to build with this help of the kit, a Bluetooth enabled smart home or Wi-Fi enabled smart home, or you can connect the things to the internet as well with the help of this kit itself. That's how the kit will play a role as a IoT laboratory. Nowadays, before starting a class, we used to take the attendance manually. Instead of going up that, in a classroom, if you fix a camera in one place, the camera will take the pictures, snapshots, at each and every 5 seconds or 10 seconds, and the snapshots will go to the cloud. So where in the cloud we have already the pictures of the students. So these pictures taken by this camera will map it to the pictures already in the cloud. After mapping the pictures, it will produce the Excel sheet to us. based upon number of hours the students presenting in the class. So this can be applied for both for students or faculty, whoever may be, by imaging. This is done with the help of deep learning algorithms. And the next application is a trendy one, IoT COVID mask. Right now we have, this is the position we are using the mask, but for the COVID we need to do the three things: social distance and temperature monitoring and N95 mask. So to do these things, this mask will fit very much. With the help of some sensors, we are putting some ultrasonic sensor to maintain the social distance. If you go closer to the any person, means automatically you will get a buzzer to maintain the distance, so that you will get an alert and you will not go near to the thing, near to the any object or any person. So you can able to easily maintain the social distance, and you have a temperature monitoring sensor. So frequently the body temperature will be monitored, and these all things will go to the cloud, so that we can give one app to the user and to any volunteer in Andhra Pradesh state or etc., or to the monitoring per person. They can able to sense the individual values with the help of an app, so that easily we can able to recognize a person, how many days they are maintaining the social distance, within a day how many times they are not maintaining the social distance, and what are the temperature levels of every day. Like that, continuously we can able to monitor with the help of this COVID mask. So how we can do these things, means by embedding the sensors into the N95 mask. So we improvising the mask. We have a surgical mask, N95 mask, other mask. So that with that to that mask, if we put some sensors to it, means automatically it will work as a COVID enabled mask. Next, this is actually kitchen dishwasher, which is very very useful for the ladies in India for the kitchen. In the kitchen, to clean the dishwashers, they really, after having a delicious food, they feel very difficult, or they feel not good to clean the dishes. For them, this is the best solution. What this thing will do, means irrespective of the size, automatically after putting the waste in separate bowl, we have to place in one place, that place will take to the cleaning basin, that will automatically clean the stuff, and that will take to the wiping thing where it will dry out all the things, and that will separate the dishes to all the things. This is how the dish washer will works, irrespective of the size. For now we have a dish cleaner with respect of size. Here, with the irrespective of the size, automatically the dish washer will be clean the kitchen. And we have some electric network recommendation system. In apartments or in a big factories or etc., we have electrical network where often we used to get some lot of troubles. With the help of the AI and machine learning algorithms, based upon the problem, automatically it will suggest the solutions. This is the beauty of this patent. So automatic railway gate system. In some places there won't be any gate man, so they won't put any gate. That's why many accidents may occur. So with this patent, what we can do is automatically, that we used to put the vibration sensor under the track near the railway gate, so it will detect before 2 to 3 kilometers away of the railway train, and automatically it will put a gate, and it will give the suggestions to the persons who walking surrounded by ringing the alarm or buzzer sound or the lights, so that the person who is trying to cross the road, with the help of the buzzer sound and with the help of the lights, they will not cross the road. And those who are installed the app kind of thing, they can able to get the messages. So in this place the train is moving, will be moved, or the gate will be closed. So you can take diversions like that. You can get some recommendation system as well with the help of this automatic railway gate system. So overload of this vehicle. So if you see nowadays in auto rickshaw or a car, more than sufficient numbers are sitting in the vehicle. For example, in auto, 3 members should sit in the auto, but 5 members, 10 members also sitting on the car. So what this application will do, means this will automatically send a alarm to the driver three times for every minutes if the weight is very more. So automatically the driver should reduce the weight. If you didn't reduce the weight, means the message will go to the RTO office with the help of what the message will go means GPS, where the particular vehicle is there, the location of the vehicle and the vehicle number to the RTO, so that he can able to take some actions. So how we can do this one means we will put a weight sensor on bottom of a body of any vehicles. Next is the dustbin management. Right now this is a dustbin. If you see in our streets or etc, the dustbin, if it get fulls as well, they will clean the dustbin after 2 days or 3 days. So if the dustbin gets full, means they must throw the dustbin in out of the places. So that is very problematic and which leads to most of diseases. That's why what we doing means we putting some two sensors in top and bottom. Top sensor will recognize whether the dustbin is full or not. Bottom one will recognize dustbin is empty. So whenever the dustbin is full, automatically the message will go to the municipality person. So the message will go to every half an hour. So within 1.5 hour he need to clean the dustbin. If he not clean the dustbin, means the same message will go to the higher authority, so that he can take action on the municipality person who is appropriate for the particular area. And there is a chance of putting the throwing the dust there itself, so that you will get the status empty. That's why what we are doing is empty. Whenever the dustbin will get empty, the particular GPS location will send to the higher authority, so that we can able to know where the location the dustbin was empty, so that in appropriate estimation, if they won't dump the dustbin in appropriate place, means they can able to take the action. This is how the dustbin management will work. So this is the applications what we have patented, and a few of these applications are already in the marketing, and the customers are feeling very happy to use this kind of applications. So up to now, we have any questions, any queries, you can leave in the comment box. You can subscribe to my YouTube channel as well, to know very clear understanding of Internet of Things and how to do this cool stuff, etc. One more thing is a weight detection device. So we don't know how much weight is there in the gas, how much gas is there in the cylinder, and in many hotels and restaurants etc, they don't know how much wastage of food is going. So with the help of this application, we putting a one weight sensor, we will supplying the weighing machine. That machine is connected with an IoT, and from IoT to the cloud and cloud to the app. So wherever the owners may be, whatever the weight you putting on the weighing machine, easily they can able to get the values on the app or in the system, so that they can able to track very easily. So this is about the applications. Any doubt regarding the applications, you can ask me, or you can leave as the comments over there. Next we will discuss about the research issues. We have a lot of research issues in an IoT. First one is authentication problem. What kind of authentication we need to use, and privacy and security. In the privacy, my home should controlled by me, not by you. If that is the case, means lot of issues will occur. How we can able to do the security issues and privacy. If you put a camera in a bedroom, how it will be. So we need to know very clearly where we can able to place the sensors and where we need to place the cameras, etc. So the privacy issues are very important. And as the devices are very less and in a size, how that can able to do the energy, and how you can able to supply the power, and what about the computation? As we giving the microcontroller, it will not perform more computations. And we connecting each and every thing to the internet. What is the scalability? For now, we have connected the devices like a laptop, desktop, and a mobile phone. With that, we are collecting terabytes of data. But if you connect each and everything to the internet, means how it will be? How where you will store the data? Whether the data storing is appropriate, the source is appropriate. So this all are the research issues what we are need to deal it out. And let me say the research challenge what I have faced during my PhD. I have done my research in the RPL protocol. I have done some detection mechanisms for the black hole, wormhole, rank hole, and the selective forwarding attacks. I have implemented these all attacks and the prevention measures with by using the CUDA simulation tool. After doing the simulation, I have done the real-time experiment in the test bed by dumping all the codes and the detection mechanisms on the test bed, and that really works good. The future in this area, the future work may be like sinkhole or gray hole, impersonator attack, and etc. etc. Many scope is there in these attacks as well. So anybody want to pursue this research in this angle as well, they can able to pursue it out. So during my research, I have done 10 patents, and I have started my startup SNB, and I have written one test book and 7 publications, and I have done the MOU with the company, multinational company Harmonizer. And currently, after completion of patent, I have completion of my PhD, I have done 15 patents, and many patents are in the marketing, and 2 test books and the 15 publications. And we have a iLab, intellectual property, intellectual lab, that we call as intellectual lab, which is organized by the established by the Harmonizer company. You can able to check this company in the website harmonizersolutions.com. It is a lab setup. This is not for CSC or ECE. This will be for whole college, irrespective of branch. This lab is useful for all the students in a college, where it has many features, where we will they will provide assistance to do research papers, conference, and patents, etc. Their intention is to fill a gap between the academician and the industry. Whatever the mini projects or major projects are doing in the academic, they want to take to the industry and marketing and etc. That's the IoT laboratory. This lab will be established with minimum cost. So anybody interested to this laboratory as well, you can able to contact these numbers. And regarding these things, if you have any questions, any suggestions, you can leave in this comment box, and you can mail me personally as well. And we selling the academic IoT laboratory kit alone for many institutions for their IoT laboratory as well. They can do it out. And already we have done a MOU with some many academic institutions like Vidyaniketan, etc. etc. Been able to do it out. And many other videos related to IoT is there in my YouTube channel. You can watch that. Once again, if you have any queries, you can leave in the comment box. Subscribe to my channel, Vikram Neergatti, for more videos in IoT. And you can leave a mail, or you can send a SMS or WhatsApp to this number. Thank you.